Okay, our next film, and our next film is an animated feature for kids called All Dogs Go to Heaven, and it's surprisingly weak. Surprising because it was created by Don Bluth, the maker of such fine animated pictures as The Land Before Time and An American Tale. The biggest problem with All Dogs Go to Heaven is its confusing story, a 30s gangster parable set in New Orleans with a small-time hoodlum dog named Charlie being killed by a mob boss dog named Carface.
I do not wish that I should share 50% of the business with my partner, Charlie.
After Charlie is killed, he goes to heaven where he fiddles with a watch that controls his destiny, sending him back to Earth alive. Back on Earth, Charlie has a lot of adventures, including befriending an orphan girl who can predict the winners of horse races.
If you're serious about this mommy and daddy business, you're going to need a little dough of your own. You know, new dresses, new shoes. I know about these things. Nobody wants a scrawny little doll in rags.
That's Burt Reynolds' voice as Charlie. The story really wanders all over the place, with Charlie dealing with everything from a house full of orphans in the style of Oliver Twist to a big green sea monster that does an Esther Williams water ballet to that little girl who comes straight out of Little Miss Marker. In addition to being confused, I found All Dogs Go to Heaven to be needlessly violent, that the dogs really lacked any kind of fresh personalities, and the drawing of the film wasn't anything special either. So thumbs down for me.
Well, this movie suffers from the fact that it comes out at the same time as The Little Mermaid, which is really an animated classic. And this is not an animated classic, but I did enjoy it, and I think you were a little bit too hard on it. I think that the plot was not that hard to follow, really. I mean, after all, this is for six-year-olds, and I think they could probably follow it.
I don't know that they can.
And I did enjoy the drawing. I think Don Bluth has tried to liberate himself from the Disney cookie-cutter factory that he left. Bluth is an animator who left Disney in 1979. To set out on his own, and with these dogs and with the other characters in the movie, including it's an alligator, not a sea monster, and I could see that it was an alligator anyway, I think he gives them a lot of personality by allowing them to stretch. They become kind of rubbery and kind of flexible, and I enjoyed that kind of animation.
I don't know that this story was worth doing. Do you think the story was worth telling?
Frequently with animated films, I have a feeling that the story is the last thing they're concerned about. I think they're concerned more with visual sequences and how things can be developed on that basis.
But what makes
and the overall plot is usually the weakest part of many animated films.
Okay, but what makes the classic ones classic is that they do have timeless stories, and this certainly
doesn't.
You
do care about them. You don't care as much about this. That's right. When we come back,